are moving out, people moving in. Why? Because of the color of the skin.
Run, 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 but you sure can't hide.
Well, nobody's interested in learning but the teacher. Segregation, determination, demonstration, integration, aggravation, humiliation.
Good morning and welcome to Detroit Wants to Know. This week we're at the Detroit Science Center. Actually, it's no longer the Detroit Science Center, it's the Michigan Science Center. And I have Tanya Matthews, the CEO of the Science Center.
Yes.
Ms. Matthews, what is this thing called, first of all, now?
It is indeed the Michigan Science Center, made in Detroit, serving the state of Michigan.
All right. We're here today
to
talk about the hot, steamy summer, the steamy summer.
Yes.
Of DPS, and that is science,
technology, engineering, arts, and math.
Yes. There you go, steamy summer.
Yes, yes, yes.
School has just let out. Mm-hmm. DPS is putting this on.
Yes.
They're going to have events here, the Nature Center, Brennan Pools, and the Wayne County Aquatic Center.
Yes.
All right, and I think it's a beautiful thing. Your family is interested. Tell me, what type of STEAM things are they going to see here at the Science Center? And then I need you to give me an overview of the Science Center itself.
Absolutely. So here at the Science Center on August 13th, we will be free and open to all of the STEAMy smart kids and their fantastic parents. And we're doing that actually in honor of teachers and educators. So that's where we're actually open for the public that day. And we also have free immunizations. So I know it may not sound like a good thing, but we need the kids to come on in and get their shots. And then we are going to reward ourselves. So STEAMy, it's not just science and art, it's the way it goes together. So when we talk about chemistry and why fireworks can be different colors, even when it's just chemicals and metals, and why are metals different colors? So we talk a little bit about that. It will be the closing weekend, one of the closing weekends for Bug Quest, which is our traveling exhibit.
Bug Quest.
Bug Quest.
What is Bug Quest?
Bug Quest. So we have a sort of a choose your own adventure. Go to the left if you don't like bugs. Go to the right if you think you do like bugs. You see the same thing, but we got the 10-foot bugs on the left side and the tarantulas that are rumored to hop into the air and take down birds on the right side. And so folks can go in and see those bugs that we have, some of the live ones and also some of the ceramic bugs we have. Of course, our planetarium, our IMAX, and 80,000 square feet of hands-on interactive STEM exhibits that folks can get into.
I feel like I've walked it already. What are your hours under normal operations, hours and prices under normal operations for families?
So this is the summer season, so we are open 7 days a week. So your excuses are done. During the week, we're open until 5 p.m. And during the weekends, we're actually open until 6 p.m. And then we have some special events. Every third Thursday of the month now, we actually shut it down for kids and we make it 21 and up here at the Science Center. So we have MySci After Dark. Yes, of course, there is a bar attached to that.
Why do you look at me and say, yes, of course, is there's a bar? Do I look like I need a bar?
No, absolutely. You do not, because you'd be interacting and
now
playing
you
with
sound
all
like
of these
my doctor.
Exhibits.
You do not need a bar.
At the same
Quit
time.
Quit while you're ahead, Dr. Matthews.
Right. Curious minds of all ages. We've got a little something for everyone.
Okay. Yes. Now, during DPS this time, what are the prices to get in? Once again, under normal circumstances.
So our general admission prices start between $12 and $14, depending on the experience that you're having. You can see all of that on our website. We've got discounts the more stuff you do. But again, we're free on August 13th.
Now, August the 13th, the steamy summer, free all day long.
It is free all day long.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Now, do parents have to register to come, or is it all set?
Parents do not have to register to come for us, but they should check DPS's website and our website around registering for immunizations. And of course, we'll be just coming up to open enrollment time. And so there's all that kind of information on the different partner websites.
Okay. I've got to get ready to go to the next segment.
Yes.
But before I go, how does somebody grow up to be the CEO of a science center? Real quick, one minute.
1 minute. So my background is in engineering. I started realizing that I like talking about math to anybody, especially poets, because they represented a challenge, but I needed a bigger classroom. I was looking for a place where I could take anybody at any level with any preparation and teach them something amazing about science, and that's what science centers do.
All right. Well, Dr. Matthews, I want to thank you very much. This is an interesting place. I've already played with some of your things
there
around
you
here. Hope I didn't break them. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back with more information on DPS's STEAMy Summer. Science, technology, engineering, art, and math. And you, that's what the Y is, STEAMy. We'll be right back from the Science Center.
It's the land of opportunity right in our own front yard.
We got our dream home at a dream price.
It's buildingdetroit.org with more homes and more ways to own.
The architecture in this neighborhood is impossible to not fall in love with.
We decided to make an offer and the bid came through.
This was the house that was meant to be.
We actually have a house. I mean, this is our house.
Register to bid, attend an open house, buildingdetroit.org. Welcome home.
Mike's Fresh Market, Detroit's largest independent supermarket with the best prices, quality, and service. Enjoy our vast selection of fresh fruits and vegetables. Wide aisles lead you to our own in-house bakery and deli. Beef, pork, chicken, seafood, and much more. You can rest assured you will feed your family the freshest food in town. Whatever you need, you can find it here at Mike's Fresh Market. Mike's Fresh Market with two locations, Gratiot and 7 Mile and Livernois and 7 Mile. Better food, better prices. That's Mike's promise.
This is Wayne County Treasurer Eric Sabri for an important message for those enrolled in payment agreements with the Wayne County Treasurer's Office. If you are enrolled in an agreement, don't default. Keep your payments current, especially if you have an interest reduction agreement which allows you to pay 6% interest per year. If you default, your interest payments will increase to 18% per year and cannot be reversed. If you have questions, contact my office. Don't default. Keep your payments current.
She didn't have to die. She was having stomach pains. She went in for a simple procedure. Something went wrong, and they accidentally punctured her lower left lung. She never made it home. It just tore us apart. Don't be afraid to stand up if you feel like a big company made a mistake. Stand up for what's right. Dan fought for me, and he will fight for you.
Welcome back to Detroit Science Center. This is Detroit Wants to Know. I have as my guest right now, Alycia Meriweather, the interim superintendent of DPS CD. Interim superintendent Meriweather, I read the STEAMy Summer flyer and I'm so impressed with the Meriweather reading list. It's the first time in my recollection that a superintendent has actually given a summer reading list. Tell us about the importance of that summer reading list.
Well, as I continue to say, reading is super important. All of us who are readers, we know that reading takes you to different places, helps you to learn new things. And really the idea behind the reading list or the challenge, I decided to call it a challenge as opposed to just a list. The list sounds like a chore, your list of books that you must read. This is a challenge to read as many books as you can. And we gave some titles as suggestions that are grade level appropriate. We've worked with the public library to make sure those books are in stock. And then we're also working to make sure that people have access to books in other ways that we'll be announcing next week. So there's a surprise is coming next week. And for right now, you can check out the reading list on the back of the flyer.
Which is coming to everybody's mailbox.
If you are a Detroit resident, It is coming to your house. So look for this coming to your house. Okay. And on the back, you have titles for each grade level, starting at pre-K all the way up through high school. And there's two titles listed for each grade level. And then if you want more challenge, go to our website and get the entire list to download.
All right. Now, during the summer enrollment, in addition to reading, you're looking for ambassadors.
We are looking for ambassadors.
And you're looking at it as a health challenge, right?
I am. And today I don't have my Fitbit on. But
I have my Fitbit on, and I'm ready to walk. For DPS CD.
Well, I will be getting in touch with you and everyone else who wants to walk for DPS CD to make sure we're walking all of our blocks, making sure people know about what great opportunities we have with Detroit Public Schools Community District. We have 97 schools. There's got to be one that works for you.
I'm so excited about your new Montessori programs that are coming up.
Yeah. Yes, we have 7 classrooms that are opening this fall at 3 locations. So Edison, Mayberry, and the third one is at Spain. So we have 7 classrooms divided between those 3 school locations. Tuition-free, Montessori, And we'll see how it goes this year and see about expanding it, but we're trying to make sure we do it excellently this fall. So check it out. Space is limited. Obviously, we only have 7 classrooms. So we're really excited about that. We've got an overage ELL classroom at Priest. We have small schools, small learning communities at DCP at Northwestern, blended learning at AL Holmes. We've got 12 different new programs that are happening this fall.
All right. Well, what I really like, I like your reading list. I like the new stuff. But I also like the emphasis on family activities of this summer. All of these activities, the DNR Outdoor Center, the Brennan Pools, the Michigan Science Center, the Wayne County Aquatic Center, the Detroit Children's Museum.
It's all focused on the family, having a good time learning.
Yes, and then there's the Open Doors Day.
Open Doors Day ends
with that. Tell us about Open Doors Day.
So Open Doors Day is on August 27th. From 10 to 1, all of the schools in Detroit Public Schools Community District will have our doors open so people can come and check us out in person, see the building, see the staff, talk with the principal, and really just get a feel for that building before they make a decision around enrollment.
Okay. One last thing. We've got this brand new thing called Pokemon Go.
Oh.
We have all sorts of video games out there. Tell the parents, look in the cameras, tell the parents why it's important for that child to read and get off of those video games. One last time.
So I do think it's really important for parents to put limits on screen time. And it's not just Pokemon Go, and it's not just iPads, movies, computers. Limit that screen time and use book time, actually, to, you know, stop FaceTiming and do book time. Because the more you read, the more you know. And we know that reading really opens up doors. And so I just want to encourage parents, it is a good thing to cut off the screen time and have kids do book time. So use the libraries, use the different places that you have as resources for books, and make sure kids are reading all summer long.
All right. Alycia Meriweather, thank you very much for joining us.
Thank you.
And thank you for introducing that reading list.
You're welcome.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back with more of Detroit Wants to Know.
What is DTE Energy doing to help support Michigan communities?
They support a lot, like the National Cherry Festival in Traverse City, Art Prize in Grand Rapids, not to mention help fund the Career Technology Center at Monroe County Community College. And also helping make the streets of Detroit safer.
Wow, that's a lot.
You're telling me, I'm exhausted. DTE Energy, know your own power.
It's all happening at the Detroit Seafood Market and PV Lounge in Paradise Valley, including happy hour weekdays 4 till 7. Mondays, it's Shrimply Paradise with 30 shrimp prepared 5 ways for $30. Tuesdays, enjoy half-price bottles of wine with dinner for 2. Wednesdays, the Detroit Seafood Market offers all-you-can-eat crab legs for $30. The Detroit Seafood Market and PV Lounge. See you there.
It's happening in neighborhoods across the city. More and more families are discovering they can own their own home, often for less per month than renting.
We got the home for a wonderful price.
The architecture in this neighborhood is impossible to not fall in love with.
It all starts at buildingdetroit.org. Register to bid, attend an open house, meet the neighbors.
We are just excited about all of the energy. It's alive, people are moving in, we're engaging with one another, and there's a strong neighborhood association here that we really, really love.
Find your dream home at a dream price.
Every morning when I wake up and come downstairs, I still say, I can't believe this is our home.
This was the house that was meant to be.
Welcome home. BuildingDetroit.org.
No. I was not supposed to live. February 8th, about 1:30 in the morning, doing my regular old job. In the process of the accident, I was in shock, but unfortunately I could hear my bones cracking. 3-4 weeks later when I woke up, I found out, you know, I was missing a leg, body was pretty much destroyed. All I had to do was find ways to heal. He was handling things that day. Ben Johnson fought for me. He would definitely fight for you.
Detroit Wants to Know is sponsored by the AFPD, the voice of independent retailers.
If you or a loved one needs help, Call the Detroit Wayne Mental Health Authority at 1-800-241-4949. The Detroit Wayne Mental Health Authority is your provider for services when you need a hand. We provide services for your whole family in substance abuse, autism services, and parent support. We are there to help with people suffering from depression, anxiety, and those with developmental disabilities. We can assist you with a variety of your mental health care needs. Housing placement for the homeless, job placement, and prescription coverage. As the largest mental health care organization in the state, it is our job to care for you from the neck up. We are the source for all your mental health needs. We are there for you and your entire family. Call us at 1-800-241-4949 or visit our website at dwmha.com.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We're still at the Science Center, and I want to talk about one of the last stops on the STEAMy Summer, and that's the DNR Outdoor Nature Center. I have Linda Walter of the DNR to tell us about it. What in the world is that big building on Atwater? What's in there?
Such a good question. The building built in 1892 used to build ships, and today we've got a little bit of up north, right downtown, in 41,000 square feet. We have waterfalls and caves, a giant tree that goes up four stories, and lots more.
Now, what is the normal price of entry into the DNR Nature Center?
If you're 13 and up, it's $5. Ages 2 to 12 is $3. Under 2 is free. And our seniors, 62 and up, they're $3 as well.
Now, let's see. DPS is going to be there. Let's see. This coming up Saturday, August 6th. Are you excited? What will the families see when they get there?
We're so excited because family engagement is everything. And in the summer, families are looking for places to go that are fun. And then maybe you get educated while you're there. And that's really what we are. We engage, there's hands-on activities. They're gonna be able to crawl in a bear den. They're gonna be able to see a full-size bear. They're gonna be able to see a life-size turkey and find out what it eats. They're gonna be able
Wait, time out. They're gonna crawl in a bear den and see a life-size bear, not a real bear.
Not a real bear. We always say that. We say, is it real to the kids? Everything in there, though, is a mount. An animal found in Michigan where you could touch fur, you could touch feathers. It's okay to touch. You can see animals that are either too shy or too dangerous to approach in the wild, and you can get the feel of how big they are and what they do. It's a wonderfully cool thing.
Okay, that sounds interesting. So DPS will be out there on August 6th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. You register at the DPS, at the Detroit K12.org website. And then it's all set.
When they come up, they're going to get wristbands special for being part of the program. We're going to have special activities, hands-on activities, tables making plaster casts of tracks about finding out how things degrade for sustainable living. Be a lot of hands-on things to do and wonderful things to learn about.
Okay. Linda, I want to thank you for coming on Detroit Wants to Know. And thank you for joining me in all this noise. And by the way, does that rope swing that you have there, will that support my girth?
Absolutely, you and your family, so come on out.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back. You won't believe where I'm taking you next. Stay tuned.
Detroit Wants to Know is sponsored by the AFPD, the voice of independent retailers.
Always there when I need it. You can just call him. All I had to do was find ways to heal. In the legal side, Mrs. Johnson said, you don't worry about that. I have that taken care of for you.
When you pick him, you're picking a family member, because that's exactly what he treats you like, a family member.
It's personal, but yeah, he was right there. It's like he's been in my life all my life.
My name is Lakia Costner.
I'm Dan Roster.
I'm Craig Rose. Ben Johnson fought for me, and he would definitely fight for you.
When you're having a heart attack, this is how it feels to your heart. And if it happens at night or on the weekend, there's only one hospital team standing by on site to save you. Cardio Team One, only at the DMC.
If you or a loved one needs help, call the Detroit Wayne Mental Health Authority at 1-800-241-4949. The Detroit Wayne Mental Health Authority is your provider for services when you need a hand. We provide services for your whole family in substance abuse, autism services, and parent support. We are there to help with people suffering from depression, anxiety, and those with developmental disabilities. We can assist you with a variety of your mental health care needs. Housing placement for the homeless, job placement, and prescription coverage. As the largest mental health care organization in the state, it is our job to care for you from the neck up. We are the source for all your mental health needs. We are there for you and your entire family. Call us at 1-800-241-4949 or visit our website at dwmha.com.
With 20 top surgeons performing over a dozen of the latest knee, hip, and joint procedures at the hospitals you know and trust, we only have one question. Where does it hurt? Orthopedics and sports medicine at the DMC. Call 888-DMC-2500. The DMC's sports medicine specialists, the official docs of our Detroit Red Wings. With offices throughout Southeast Michigan and more than 30 rehabilitation locations, we can make you feel better in all these places. Call 888-DMC-2500.
This is Wayne County Treasurer Eric Sabree for an important message for those enrolled in payment agreements with the Wayne County Treasurer's Office. If you are enrolled in an agreement, don't default. Keep your payments current, especially if you have an interest reduction agreement which allows you to pay 6% interest per year. If you default, your interest payments will increase to 18% per year and cannot be reversed. If you have questions, contact my office. Don't default. Keep your payments current.
Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. We've left the Science Center and now we're on Calvert Street. Say, Steve Hood, what are you doing on Calvert Street? Well, you know, I've been watching the land bank for years. We've been talking about it. It's been bandied about in the news, all their demolition issues and all this. But guess what? They just finished tearing down over 8,000 houses. Yes, Mayor Duggan announced 10,000, but 8,000 or so of those were the land banks. But it's much more than about tearing down houses for the land bank. When I go up to the land bank, I see hope. I see hope sitting, waiting to be served, and then they're served. And what is that hope? That hope turns into something like 72 Calvert. This house was dilapidated, and they brought it back to life in a neighborhood that's struggling to survive, but they brought it back to life. I have Craig Folley with me. Craig, congratulations on the demolitions, but that's not all. Everybody thinks it's all about demolitions at the land bank. Demolition this, sig tarp this, blah, 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 blah. It's about much more than that. Well,
demolitions are a huge part of what we're doing, because if we're going to rebuild neighborhoods in Detroit, obviously it's tough to have a vision for the future of a neighborhood if there's a lot of blighted structures. But what people don't realize is that, you know, there are a whole lot of these houses that we want to save. This is just one example. This is waiting for somebody to come in and rehab it. So this is going to be up for auction this week. It's a great neighborhood. You're two blocks away from Boston Edison. We've got houses like this all over the city that can be preserved and should be preserved. And so, you know, every house has a history, and anytime we can save one, it's a great thing.
Now, is this is just a rehabbed house?
This one is not rehabbed yet. This one is waiting for somebody's
really?
Touch.
But and, I see new windows.
Well, there have been. Somebody obviously started work on this property, either gave up or lost it. We're not, you know, we got it through the foreclosure process. Houses come to us after people have not bid on them at the county auction. Mm-hmm. We get them no matter the condition. We have to take those houses. So we have to go through 30,000 homes in our inventory, find out which ones can be salvaged. And anytime we have one in a neighborhood like this, we want to make sure we don't have to tear this place down.
Well, I think it's great. It stabilizes this area.
Absolutely.
Now, you're doing this all over the city.
Yes, we have. We auction off three houses every single day on our website at buildingdetroit.org.
And is it buildingdetroit.org?
Buildingdetroit.org.
Okay.
And so it's one word, buildingdetroit.org. And if you hit buildingdetroit.com, it'll take you to the right place too. But so we made sure that we made that happen mm-hmm. so people don't get confused.
When I'm up in your office, I see people with hope. They're on your little computers, they're looking through, your assistants mm-hmm. are helping them look through the properties. Tell the viewer, because there may be viewers from the suburbs that say, you know what, I want to take a chance on Detroit. I want to buy low, I want to sell high. Like Calvert is coming back. It's just north of Boston Edison. Mm-hmm. It's just north of the M1 line. It's coming back, but some of your other neighborhoods are coming back too. So tell them the process of bidding, because this one is going to be up this week.
Yep, it is. It's coming up on the 2nd of August. So it's, I think that's Wednesday, if I'm not mistaken.
That's
so
right.
It's going to be up in just a couple of days. The bidding starts at 9 o'clock in the morning each day and ends at 5 o'clock. So this is a one-day process for each of these properties. The first thing somebody needs to do is go to the website and register. And so you
at Build Detroit.
At buildingdetroit.org. Just
building
go there.
Detroit.
It says register to bid. You click on it. There's just a little form you have to fill out. You'll need a credit card with $1,000 worth of room on it, because the minimum bid on these properties is $1,000. So you register to bid, you put the information in, and then as the day goes on, you put your bid price in, you watch the auction, you can up your bid if you want to. If you're really interested in getting a house like this, you might want to keep bidding up if there's some competition for it. Maybe there isn't. Whatever the winning bid price is, we'll take $1,000 out of your account that day. So if you get it for $1,000, pretty much you just have to come in and sign a few papers, mm-hmm. and you'll be able to close very, very quickly on the property.
And you'll get a clean title?
Yep, absolutely. Our auction properties have titles cleared. There's no past liens or water bills on these houses. So it's an important thing for people to know.
Let's go back to demolition for a second. Mm-hmm. You told me about this area just on the old west side. Mm-hmm. Were you taking out a whole area?
Yeah, well, not an entire area, but there's a lot of wonderful houses still left in this area, just to the west of LaSalle Gardens over there. So streets like Euclid Street, Whitney Street over there, where there are a lot of houses that are too far gone. We have to take them down. So we're doing a concentrated blitz in that neighborhood, frankly. We're going to take down well over 100 homes in that neighborhood. And been over there talking to the neighbors, getting them prepared for what's coming, letting them know there's going to be a lot of equipment, a little bit of noise, but in about a month's time, we're going to take down over 100 houses in that neighborhood. And I've been getting hugs, I've been getting people shaking my hand, asking, okay, what's next? And that's what we want to engage the citizens on is, all right, what do you want to see? You know, we're going to finally get these neighborhoods to a place where we have a clean slate from which to work, to start rebuilding the neighborhoods and repopulating the neighborhoods. Because that's really the ultimate goal. Save as many of these as we can, get them occupied with people, and start rebuilding the population here in Detroit.
Well, as a Detroiter, I'm gonna tell you, every time I see you guys getting beat up about demolition, it bothers me, because I love my city. And you usually get beat up by suburbanites. That's the funny part is, you're getting beat up more by suburbanites than the people that actually live here and have to deal with this.
Mm-hmm.
All right, I think this is a great thing that you're doing. Give us the website again. Give us the auction dates and the auction times one more time.
Well, it's buildingdetroit.org. That's the address. Three houses up for bid every single day, 7 days of the week, with the exception of a couple of holidays. But there are three houses every single day. So if this isn't the one that you want, there might be something on the west side. There might be something on the east side. We've got houses all over the city. And we have open houses, so you can get information on when you can see these properties before they go up for bid. There are photos of all the houses on the website as well. There's also a report that shows you what repairs need to be made to get the house up to code, which is an important part of this. And we give residents a lot of help in trying to find ways to get these places rehabilitated.
All right, Craig Folley, thank you very much for your time.
Pleasure. Always
and,
pleasure.
I haven't been on Calvert in so long. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll see you next week. Have a great one.
Skin. Run, 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 but you sure can't hide.